Hello friends and welcome back. So today we will discuss about buffer overflow attacks and how attackers exploit this vulnerability and what steps you can take to safeguard your systems. So without wasting any time, grab a notepad and let's begin. What is buffer overflow? In programming and information security, a buffer overflow or buffer overrun is an anomaly whereby a program writes data to a buffer beyond the buffer's allocated memory, overwriting adjacent memory locations. A buffer is a temporary storage area in any program's memory. When a program tries to load more data into a buffer that it can hold, that extra data spills over into adjacent memory locations, and which can lead to unexpected behaviors like crashing the system or allowing attackers to gain control of the system. For example, imagine a box meant to hold a specific number of apples. A buffer overflow is like stuffing too many apples into that box, but instead of overflowing onto the floor, this extra data spills over into neighboring boxes, right? Buffer overflow vulnerability, how attackers exploit this vulnerability. There are majorly four steps. Finding the vulnerability, attackers identify a program with a buffer overflow vulnerability. This could be due to programming errors where the program doesn't check how much data it's receiving. Suppose a program that takes user input like your name and stores it in a designated memory space called a buffer. This buffer has a fixed size, like a box with limited space, right? The vulnerability arises when the program lacks proper checks on the incoming data. An attacker can exploit this by sending more data than the buffer can hold. This creates a chaotic situation where the extra data is spilled over, overflowing the buffer, right? Attacker's arsenal, malicious payload. They create a special input, often exceeding the buffer's capacity, and insert malicious code within it. This overflowing data becomes the attacker's weapon, called a malicious payload. It's like stuffing the box with extra apples and adding a hidden knife in that mix. So, malicious payload is like a hidden knife in the box of apples, which we discussed earlier. The payload often contains two key components. Overflow data, this initial part fills the buffer and triggers the overflow. It's like filling the box with enough apples to reach the top. Next is malicious code. This hidden code sits cleverly within the payload. It's like the knife concealed among the apples. Overflowing the buffer, the attacker tricks the program into accepting this overflowing payload. So things get critical when the overflowing data reaches adjacent memory locations. This is like the extra apples spilling over into neighboring boxes, right? Crucially, these adjacent locations might hold critical information like the program's return address, and the return address tells the program where to go after finishing a task, right? Think of return address as a bookmark for the program. It tells the program exactly where to resume execution after the function finishes its job, right? Taking control and code execution. By overflowing the buffer, the attacker can overwrite the return address with their own malicious code address. It's like replacing the program's return instruction with a bypass to the hidden knife, the attacker's code, right? When the program finishes its task, it doesn't return to its intended location. Instead, it jumps to the attacker's code embedded in the overflow data. This code executes with the same privileges as the original program, granting the attacker unauthorized access to the system. The attacker uses the program's own functionalities against itself, right? Since we have recently discussed in details about cloud computing and hypervisors, so this vulnerability is also present there as well. Hypervisor buffer overflows. These target vulnerabilities within the hypervisor software, which manages multiple virtual machines on a single physical machine, right? A successful attack grants control over the hypervisor itself, potentially impacting all virtual machines running on the system. How you can prevent and mitigate the risk of buffer overflows? So there are several ways to prevent buffer overflows and mitigate their vulnerabilities. So we will discuss this on the programmer side and on the user side, what are the steps to take to prevent buffer overflows, right? On the programmer side, secure coding practices, programmers can adopt techniques like bounce checking. Bounce checking involves checking the size of incoming data before storing it in a buffer to ensure it doesn't overflow. It's like measuring the apples before putting them in the box to avoid overflowing, right? Use safe functions. Many programming languages offer functions specifically designed to handle strings and memory allocations with built-in bounce checking. This reduces the risk of programmers accidentally creating buffer overflows. And input validation. Programs should validate user input to prevent unexpected characters or excessive data from entering the system. It's like having a quality check on the apples before putting them in a box. Only good quality apples go in, right? And on the user side, keeping software up to date with security. These patches are like installing a stronger box lid to prevent overflowing. Using trusted software, downloading software from trusted sources can help reduce the risk of encountering problems with known buffer overflow vulnerabilities. Being cautious with user input, users should be cautious while entering data into programs, especially from untrusted sources. Avoid opening suspicious attachments or clicking on unknown links, right? So by implementing these preventive measures on both the programmer and the user sides, we can significantly reduce the risk of buffer overflow attacks and make our systems more secure. Let us look at some of the famous examples where buffer overflows were used by hackers to cause major problems. One was in 1988, Morris worm. It crashed many computers on the early internet. This infamous worm did exploit buffer overflows. It targeted vulnerabilities in programs used to provide user information and used for sending emails. By overflowing buffers in these programs, the Morris worm could gain unauthorized access and replicate itself across the early internet, right? In 2001, Code Red worm, which affected millions of computers running Microsoft software. This worm exploited a buffer overflow vulnerability. It targeted a flaw in Microsoft Internet Information Services web server software. By overflowing a buffer, the Code Red worm could modify web server files and deface websites, impacting millions of computers. So these worms exploited buffer overflow vulnerabilities and caused significant damage. So guys, this is all we have for today. We have understood how buffer overflows remain a significant cybersecurity threat. Thank you guys for patiently listening. If you like this video, please share and subscribe to our channel. Consider joining me on LinkedIn. See you soon with another topic, another video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.